Dear members, good evening. We are saddened to inform the fraternity of the passing of Dr. Guru Kumar Balachandra Parulkar, the 12th president of the Indian Association of Cardiac Thoracic and Vascular Surgeons, 2 days back after a long innings with life at the age of 91. Dr. Parulkar's legacy endures today through the numerous trainees and fellows who are today chiefs, professors, and directors of cardiac thoracic surgery across the country and the world. His legacy can be traced down to over 100 cardiac thoracic surgeons in practice today. Likewise, his impact on the Indian Association of Cardiac Thoracic Surgeons remains hard to quantify during his years of service to the league as executive committee member, member of the editorial board, secretary, and then the president. His influence on shaping the sustenance of our association was so proud that his contributions and the association with ISCTS lasted over 55 years. The importance of surgical leadership and scholarship was equally prominent in his life that several of his mentees and theirs followed in Dr. GVP's footsteps to lead the association in subsequent years. Dr. Parulkar, fondly known as GVP to his students and colleagues, was respected as a teacher par excellence, caregiver, and a mentor. He rendered himself as a pillar of compassion and healing to those who needed it the most, whether known or unknown. He pioneered several surgical techniques much ahead of the contemporary work around the world with deep hypothermic circuit arrest for the correction of complex congenital and aortic diseases. The association was extremely dear to him, and he continued to transform the Indian Association of Cardiac Thoracic and Vascular Surgeons through his leadership and focused on transforming the association into the international, educational, and research-oriented organization that it is today. His mentorship will continue to have a lasting effect on the bearing of our association for the years to come. Today, in his remembrance, we are having a condolence meeting, and I extend an invitation to all his students, colleagues, and family members, especially Dr. Raju, Amla, and the Gannett Sujata, and also family members of Dr. Manke. Dr. Alka Manke is here with us, and all his colleagues. Having lost one of the greatest stalwarts in our cherished profession, the Indian Association of Cardiac Thoracic and Vascular Surgeons would like to observe 1 minute silence before we start this meeting. Thank you, sir. Now I request our president, Dr. K.S. Iyer, to share a few words.
Good evening, respected seniors, friends, colleagues. It's a solemn occasion that we gather today to remember Dr. G.B. Parulkar, who left us for his heavenly abode a short while ago. In his loss, the Indian Association of Thoracic Cardiovascular Surgery has lost one of the giants and also one of the pillars on whose strength the association stands. I never had the fortune of being a student of Dr. Parulkar or having trained or worked with him. But in my training days during MCH and in my tenure as a young consultant, Dr. Parulkar and his team at the KM Hospital was always something that we looked up to. For us at the All India Institute, the surgeons from Bombay were the pioneers and the leaders in the field. And the group of four at the KM Hospital, led by Dr. Parulkar, the others being Dr. Bhattacharya, Dr. Sharad Pandey, and Dr. A.P. Chokar, That was such a formidable team and an awe-inspiring team that we used to look forward to every conference where we'd get an opportunity to meet them and listen to their presentations, because we knew that they were going to be way ahead of any of the rest of the country. Dr. Parulkar always took an interest in my work, because I think he started off with congenital heart surgery, and that still remained in his heart as a passion. And so at every conference that we would meet, he would keep asking me about work in congenital heart surgery and the progress, etc. And they were very interesting, and obviously I learned a lot from those conversations. But I'm sure his students who directly trained with him and worked with him would have a lot more to share about their experience with him. And I will not take too much of the time, except to say that may he find eternal peace wherever he is. And I would like to convey on behalf of the association a condolence to the family and our prayers that they have the strength to bear with this loss. I'm sure he would leave a vacuum in everybody's heart, but that is unfortunately the way of life. But it's only right that we remember his contributions to the association on this day. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Let me brief, sir, how we are going about. Like, we have more than 54 members who have joined the meeting today. It's very kind of them. And we'll be having 3 minutes to share the memories of each person, sir. I will be calling out the name of the persons, his students, colleagues, and all accordingly. And before that, sir, I would request Dr. Tendulkar to kindly introduce the family members of Dr. Parulkar, sir. You can unmute yourself, sir. Yes.
We are really honored to have his son and daughter joining us. Unfortunately, Dr. Parulkar's wife, Suman, who was head of the Department of Physiology at BYL Nair Hospital, passed away in January. We are joined by Raju. Raju, though we popularly call him Raju, as per the tradition, his official name is his grandfather's name, is Balchandra Guru Kumar Parulkar. Raju is an accomplished urologist and he settled in Boston and he's married to Smita. I'm not sure what specialty she is in now. Raju, you are there. Can you brief us about you, you know?
Smita is in internal medicine. And okay. She's like a MD physician in India. And, okay. I'm attached to one of the academic hospitals. I'm chief of urology there. Okay. I'm president of the medical staff in a second hospital. But it's essentially, we have been in this community since we came back to USA in 93.
Okay. And now we are also joined by Amla, his daughter. I think I saw Amla. Yeah. Amla is an anesthesiologist and she is married to Vivek. Vivek is a pediatric surgeon. And we all must thank both of them for taking an extremely good care of Baba and I. Sir and Madam, Amla, we are really, really very, very thankful to you for the excellent care you and Vivek took for last so many years. Amla is blessed with a daughter and she is an infectious medicine specialist practicing in Pune. So Amla, we are honored. Raju, we are honored. And back to you, Hiremat. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. I call upon Dr. Padma Bhushan, Dr. M.S. Valiathan to kindly say a few words.
Friends, I'm greatly saddened to hear the news of DB passing away. I must first of all convey my sincere condolences to the members of the family. Dr. Parulkar, I first came in touch with him in 1962. I had just come back from Philadelphia and KEM Hospital, I joined as a pool officer. Professor P.K. Sen was the head of the department and Parulkar was an assistant professor. Our acquaintance, friendship goes back to those days. And I moved away after 2 or 3 months. I went to PGI Chandigarh, then I was a citizen of the world traveling all over. But we always remained in touch. In fact, when he came as a visiting fellow, traveling all over the United States, he came and stayed with me in Washington for a day or two, I remember that. But I can only say that Dr. Parulkar, the conditions of cardiac surgery in those days, Professor Sen had a small experimental lab at KEM. He had assembled Parulkar. Suman Kinnare was doing the pathology. And Dr. Gandhi used to run a primitive heart-lung machine. I remember very well, I used to go there every day to work with them. From those days, KEM has become one of the foremost centers for cardiac surgery. And after P.K. Sen, it was GB who did the building of this institution. As a president of the association, as a mentor for a generation of students, he has played a key role in building cardiac surgery and reaching it to the present state of a high point. So I would like to pay my tribute to him, and I hope that we'll continue to honor him in a suitable way in the association. I would like to join with all of you in paying my obeisance to him. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I invite Dr. K.M. Cherian, sir, to speak a few words.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Please go ahead, sir.
Okay. Now, first of all, thank you for giving me the opportunity. Secondly, you know, I would like to pay my tribute to the family. Now, my acquaintance with GB has been from 1975. In fact, it was not very pleasant one. The reason why I'm saying is, well, in 1975, September, I think that Indian Cardiology Society meeting was in Chennai. And I came back in 1975, June. And so during that meeting, I wanted to present the first bypass surgery. And in fact, Dr. Parulkar and A.K. Basu were the chairman. And they said, there is no time. So I could not present on 11th. The 12th morning, I was asked to present the same thing by Professor the Professor of Cardiology in All India Institute. Anyway, you know, I mean, from that time onwards, you know, for a long time, he has been a very supportive senior colleague. And in 1992, I think Dr. Jairaj, who was the secretary, he went off to Muscat. And the secretary post of the IACTS was vacant. And Dr. Parulkar and K.R. Shetty, with the support of Dr. Gujral, made me the secretary without any election. Naturally, in 1993, I think I became the president. And for all important functions, I used to invite GB, and he used to come and encourage me in doing whatever I was doing at that time. Then I remember distinctly that Asia Pacific meeting in Sydney, the Indian contingent was asked to give some entertainment. And GB used to like my wife. And he said, you know, you should join me. And they sang one popular Hindi song, which I can't remember. Anyway, we all joined and we were about 12 or 13 from India. So that was the second, and the last meeting was in January 2020, just before the COVID. I went to his apartment where he was staying with his sister, and even though people used to think that you know, he could not remember. He immediately recognized me, and we exchanged pleasantries, and he said, "I'm sorry that I can't offer you a cup of coffee." I said, "I didn't come here to get a cup of coffee from you, but I came here to see you." And that was the last meeting I had. Anyway, whatever it is, I can tell you only one thing. He may be absent in body, but as you know, absence makes the heart glow fonder. So may his soul rest in peace. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. I now like to invite Dr. Dev Pardhani. Dr. Dev, you are there, sir?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
In very brief, if I want to describe Dr. Parulkar's relations with me, we were together for a very, very long time. I can call him my elder brother. Though I was not a cardiovascular man. We got along because he was senior and we sat in the same lobby, all the staff members. We could walk in and out of anybody's office except Dr. P.K. Sen's without knocking the door. And I got involved in cardiovascular section because along with Dr. Samsi and Dr. Gandhi, I was asked to help the department for running the cardiovascular extracorporeal circulation heart lung machine, help them. And that stood me very well when we did our first kidney transplant, first three kidney transplants starting in 1965. Because that helped me to put arrange to put the cadaver on extracorporeal circulation as soon as the patient was declared dead. So that was a great association, you know, academic association. And apart from so many other things which I learned from him, the other contribution that I very distinctly remember was that he helped set up an animal laboratory, dog lab, we should call it, on our department. And that helped every one of us in the department to do experimental work, operative or otherwise, and sharpen their techniques and learn more about the work they were doing. And again, I recall that particular, I sharpened my techniques of the kidney transplant by doing so many cases of dog kidney transplants in that lab. And Dr. Parulkar was helpful in all along this time. Well, I could go on and on, but we don't have much time. I can only say that he was a man who was available to anybody, everybody in the department. And I never seen him lose his temper. You had any problem, you could go to him without an animation. You can just tell him what you want personally or otherwise. And you were always helpful. It is one of the saddest things that I'm remembering now that he's no more. And my best wishes for the family. The one thing that I did for his department was that I prevented him from making his son Raju a cardiovascular surgeon. I made him a urologist. And he became a noted urologist. Now he's in USA. And we had very close relations and we still have. But I will remember Dr. Parulkar as a very, very personal, at a very personal level apart from the academic level. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So I will invite Dr. Sushila Sripath.
Thank you.
Yeah, please go ahead, madam.
Am I audible? Yeah.
Yeah, please.
Okay. So I was a trainee at the IPJMR when I used to see Dr. Parulkar come frequently. And I think Dr. Basu used to like him very much. And I remember when Dr. Basu retired as the governor of the fellow of the American College of Surgeons, he chose Dr. Parulkar as his successor. And then I remember in 1969, they had come on a visit, he and some of his team members. And I was then working as a research officer in the experimental surgical research laboratory. And we had a demonstration of a heart-lung specimen along with the trachea and a beating, ventilated and beating heart. So you could do all kinds of biochemical tests and physiological studies on the heart and lung function. So after that, of course, I lost a contact because I was transferred here, there, and everywhere. And then finally, of course, as an examiner, I used to meet him quite often. And I was also lucky to have him as an examiner when I was holding the MCT examination in medical college. One of the important things I found is he was always a very likable person, very easily accessible, and it's easy to sort of converse. And I found he was actually a bridge generation between the pioneers and my generation. So it was a very, very important kind of association for me. And then another thing, I'm sure many of you must have read the second Henry Ford Symposium, which is a classic watershed, I think, which covered a lot of and had a lot of pioneers visiting. One of the things I found was he was one of the only discussant in that symposium. And he was also, I've got a picture of his in the audience. And I think that was in 1975. So he had a lot of contribution, a lot of friends across the globe, and I pay my homage to him. I remember him very well as an excellent person and a human being. Thank you very much.
Thank you, madam. I would like to invite Dr. Sampath Kumar, please.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to speak. First of all, let me convey my sincere condolences to his family and his colleagues and friends who were very closely associated with him. GB was a very prominent, flamboyant cardiac surgeon from Bombay. Perhaps many of you don't know, but he was the first recipient of the Graham Traveling Fellowship from the American Association of Thoracic Surgery. Fortunately, one of my students, the second recipient from India. It was indeed a great honor to have met him. He was my examiner, and we were scared at the manner in which he used to throw questions at us. But we knew behind that aggressive attitude was a good man, and we did not have any problem passing our exams in 1976. So I want to convey my sincere condolences to his family. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I would like to invite Dr. Venugopal.
It was a great pleasure to be known to Dr. Parulkar. Dr. Parulkar was a great teacher. He is a leader. He is an accomplished cardiovascular surgeon and is one of those pioneers, especially in the cardiovascular surgery in the transplantation program, where he, along with Dr. Peter Sen, he did the second transplantation in the country. And when I was doing my cardiac surgery, he used to come, and because he's close associate of Dr. Gopinath, he used to come to All India Institute, and we used to have a discussion. And he, as a teacher, as an examiner, was very friendly, cordial, and he was a leader to accolade. And it's a great honor that he got to the Padma Bhushan and also the ICMR award, and I was fortunate to get them along with him. And I convey my heartfelt condolences to the association and to the family of the Dr. Parulkar, G.B. Parulkar. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Go to Dr. Devsaxena, please.
Well, friends, it's a very sad day that we meet under difficult circumstances to mourn our friend, Dr. G.B. Parulkar. Of course, G.B. and I have never worked together. We were on one side of the road, he was on the other side of the road. But we had good relationship and all the time we used to meet at the conferences and stuff. G.B. was a great person and he was a great source of inspiration, particularly to the Indian Association of Cardiothoracic Surgeons. And as a cardiothoracic community, we'll miss him. On the association's behalf and all his friends' behalf, I would like to pay my condolences to the family and also to the association for losing a wonderful surgeon. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I call upon Dr. Pitambar Chattopadhyay, sir. Dr. Pitambar, you are there, sir, on board. Dr. Chattopadhyay, you are there. I'd like to call Dr. Ashok Kanitkar. Dr. Ashok, you are there. Yeah, please go ahead, sir. Kindly unmute yourself. So please unmute yourself. Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Yeah. Well, G.B. was like an elder brother to me. And first of all, my heartfelt condolences to Dr. Raju and Amla. I don't know whether they remember me, because I and Dr. Chaukar used to visit Dr. Parulkar in his apartment behind the KEM quite often when Raju and Amla were still kids. Dr. Parulkar and somehow I developed excellent relationship from the day I stepped into KEM hospital in 1963. I remember the first day I went to the dean's office. And the dean, Dr. Jogalekar, was sitting on one side, and in the dean's chair was this formidable figure of Professor Sen. And he asked me, "You want to learn cardiac surgery?" I said, "Yes, sir." So he said, "Go to the experimental lab today and learn how to disassemble, clean, and reassemble the heart-lung machine. You will not step into the general surgery ward for 6 months." That's all he said. I was so dejected, and the only person I thought I should go and see was Dr. Parulkar. Somehow he took pity on me and interceded with Professor Sen, and a week later I was allowed to enter the general surgery ward. G.B. was very great. He helped me all through my career. He helped us. He actually came and helped me for the first three open heart surgeries I did at Sassoon General Hospital in Pune. He's a great friend. We had kept in touch, and I'm very, very sorry and grieved at the loss of this very, very great man. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Kolna, I will invite Dr. R.S. Rajan. Is there? Dr. Arvind P. Chaukar, sir, is there?
Yes.
Please go ahead, sir.
Hello. I was his house surgeon in 1962-63. And what I remember is, I had never done an appendicectomy because he used to do general surgery. Dr. P.K. Sen had a general surgery unit and I was house surgeon in that unit, which means on first bed you see acute abdomen, on the second bed you see a bronchiectasis, and third bed is a mitral stenosis or something like that. So I had not done any appendicectomy because there are not too many cases of that type. And an emergency at 2:30 in the morning, there was acute appendicitis. So I called up Dr. Parulkar. I was a house surgeon at that time. So he said, "Yes, don't worry, I'll come down." So everybody said, "Don't worry, he'll come and do it." And I was pleasantly surprised that he stood on the other side and he says, "I will help you how to do and teach you how to do appendicectomy." So 2:30 in the morning, after being completely disturbed, he stood there and taught me appendicectomy as the first operation in general surgery, and that too in acute appendicitis. He continued to help me in mitral operations and took me to experimental lab twice a week and helped me to do heart transplant, lung transplant, which was my MCH thoracic dissertation topic. And I had a long, long association with him. For 12 and a half years, I was there in KEM. And then when I went to Sion, I continued to meet him often whenever I had some problem. I will miss him all my life. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I would like to invite Dr. Balram Iyer. Sir, you are there. Dr. V.V. Bashi is there. Dr. Bashi.
Yeah.
Please go ahead, sir.
Yeah, can you hear me? Yeah.
Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Thank you, Hiramath. First of all, my heartfelt condolences to the family of Professor Perulkar. My first interaction was with him when he came as an examiner in Vellore. And he used to be a regular examiner until 1985. He used to be so nice. And one of the things I always remember is those days when we come for conferences, he used to be very active. And I used to be waiting for the sessions he chair in all the meetings, because he makes you, when you are giving a talk, you make you very, very nice, especially when the initial period when you are presenting a paper, you are very nervous. So he makes you calm, you make you very comfortable. Plus, we used to have very good interactions those days between open mitral valve vertebrae and closed mitral valve vertebrae.
You're on.
Dr. Stanley John. And,
you want to stay on or you want to get off?
Closed valve vertebrae and Professor Baruch always used to be a proponent of open valve vertebrae. And we used to be listeners to all this. Very nice interaction along with Dr. Saxena, Dr. Then Sharad Pandey, Dr. Namesha, Dr. K.R. Shetty. And he organized a very big conference in 1985, the World Congress of Open Heart Surgery, which was well taken. So many pioneers, I still remember, all the pioneers in the world. And he was an excellent organizer. That's one of the big qualities I used to encourage everybody to join. So many times, so many international associations, everybody wanted to become a member. He keep on sending letters, please join, I will recommend you. So I have been his beneficiary in so many ways. And the biggest tribute to him is, I see the galaxy of surgeons, the biggest tribute to a teacher is all his students are doing par excellence in different parts of the world. And that is the biggest tribute. And I take this opportunity again, once again, my pronouns to him and his family. May his soul rest in peace.
Thank you, sir. Next, Dr. Suresh Rao is there, sir. Dr. Merwal, you are there, sir. Dr. Vinayak Shukla, can you unmute yourself, sir?
Yeah. Hi, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Our deepest condolences to the family, howsoever inadequate they may be at this moment in time. Surgeons and persons like Dr. Parulkar, they don't die. They will live in the many theaters that are being run by his students all over the country and abroad. Thank you very much.
Dr. Shirish Borkar is there, sir.
As Dr. Jayet Karbashi.
Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Dr. Karbashi, sir.
Dr. Jayet Karbashi, can you please go ahead, sir? Kindly unmute yourself, sir. We are unable to hear you. Sir, please unmute yourself. Unmute yourself.
Karbashi, sir, unmute.
Please go ahead, sir.
I happen to know Parulkar, sir, from 1971. He was our MBBS examiner in surgery. I myself and each one of us sensed his charisma. A tall, handsome personality with penetrating voice. An extremely helpful examiner. All fear used to disappear. And he was so appreciative of the students. That time, I never dreamt that this man is going to have a life-changing effect on me. I was his MCA student in 1975. I look back, he has given me a helping hand at every step, as a house surgeon, as MCH examination, selection of staff position at KEM. His support continued when I was at Nayan Hospital as professor and head. He was guru in true sense. I never forget his night rounds. He used to visit ICCU, he used to call it as LIC, 12 o'clock at midnight. His time, he used to sit for at least 2 hours. He was relaxed. Apart from taking patient care, he used to ask about personal difficulties also at that time. ICTS conference, he used to be joined. He was in jolly mood in this. And he could be easily spotted in company with Dr. K.R. Shetty and Dr. G.S. Gujral. In conference, we realized that what is his status? Virtually everyone in the conference from India and abroad knew him and respected him. Last time I called him 3 years back at MGM Medical College, we are keen to felicitate him, but this did not happen. His past students, we were to meet him at his residence at Haji Ali. We were all persuaded not to meet him. If someone decides to make a movie on cardiac surgery in India, Dr. Parulkar will be the hero's role. I am aware of all other cardiac surgeons and their contribution. But mind you, he was the only Indian cardiac surgeon from India on whom a short note was asked in MCH examination. Most of the candidates wrote 3-page answers. I can say in Marathi, Jhale Bahu, Hotila Bahu, Paranti Yasamaha. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I would like to invite Dr. Mrs. Alka Nityanand Manke to tell us a few words. Madam, you are there? Yeah, please go ahead, madam.
Dr. Parulkaran Baddal kiti bolavat itka kami ahe. Te kunachahi itka prachanda kautuk karayche ani spontaneously ani tyana mahit asaycha ki ani agdi junior डॉक्टर पासून ते इंटरनॅशनली फेम कोणी असू दे त्यांच्याबद्दल ते केव्हाही झोपेतून उठवून सुद्धा बोलू शकायचे आणि नेहमी प्लेझंट. मी नीतू मांडके ओरेशन सुरू केलं तर प्रत्येक वर्षी ते हजर राहिले आणि ऍक्टिव्हली मार्गदर्शन पण करत होते. गेल्या काही वर्षात मात्र त्यांची उणीव खूपच भासत होती आणि अशा तऱ्हेने जरा खूप वाईट वाटतंय की आपण शेवटपर्यंत ते त्यांच्या टच मध्ये राहू नाही शकलो कारण भेटूनही काही उपयोग नव्हता अशा प्रकारचं झालं. त्याच्याबद्दल वाईट वाटतंय पण खूप मोठा माणूस आणि आज मला ही संधी दिली त्याबद्दल खूप खूप धन्यवाद. त्या नेतूचे आणि त्यांचे खूप वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारचे संबंध होते आणि तरीही छान ते कौतुकच करायचे तरी सुद्धा नेतूचं तो काही बोलायचं त्यांना खूप छान होते ते. धन्यवाद.
थँक्यू मॅडम. लाईक टू इन्व्हाइट डॉक्टर सुधीर भाटे प्लीज. डॉक्टर सुधीर भाटे यू आर देअर सर. या प्लीज गो अहेड सर. काइंडली अनम्यूट युअर सेल्फ.
कॅन यू हिअर मी?
या प्लीज गो अहेड सर.
या वेल आय हॅव टू से वन व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट अँड अ स्टोरी दॅट आय विल ऑलवेज रिमेंबर.
सर व्हिडिओ ऑन ठेवा. व्हिडिओ ऑन
ठेवायला
पुट युअर व्हिडिओ ऑन सर.
या आय एम ट्राइंग टू डू दॅट बट समथिंग.
या नो प्रॉब्लम प्लीज गो अहेड सर. नो प्रॉब्लम प्लीज गो अहेड सर.
इट वॉज सेरेंडिपिटी दॅट ब्रॉट अस टुगेदर अँड इट अफेक्टेड माय लाईफ थ्रू आउट द इयर. इट वॉज 1970 registrar's post in general surgery and he had come to assist Dr. Kanetkar for open heart surgery. After the operation he just talked to me and asked few simple questions of cardiac surgery which I was knowing because I was working in the cardiac unit with Dr. Kanetkar. So he said, what are your plans now? So I said, I'm applying for a post in railway for a general surgeon. I said, why? why you are applying there? You come to KM. I said, what will I do to KM? He said, there is a post of senior registrar which is falling vacant, and you apply for that post. I went there, I filled the form, I was called for the interview. There were four candidates, and I was selected for the post. He changed my destiny forever. One, I was decided to become a general surgeon, and then I became a cardiac surgeon. It was only because I think a will of providence through Dr. G. Paruka. I found him an excellent teacher and an excellent advisor and companion. We had a long relationship. I was his first student to do MS cardiac surgery. And then he helped me a lot to prepare for this surgery. He taught me simple things, but they were very, very important. How to take the pursing on a beating heart. Why pursing is important when you do mitral valvulotomy, closed mitral valvulotomy, because I've seen terrible accidents occurring during mitral valvulotomy, left atrial appendage getting torn and patient landing in emergency. Third thing he used to say, how to introduce cannula in the femoral artery without dissecting it. And lastly, he said, you must always take precautions to preserve left ventricle by preventing its distension. So these were the basic things which he hammered me whenever he used to come and assist me for surgery. He was a multifaceted man, and you could put him in any category and he would do justice to that. He was an excellent surgeon, excellent administrator, excellent teacher, excellent clinician, and he had an act of organizing seminars or some meetings. I feel very sad that 1915, when we had get together in KM, we did not meet later on, though we promised to meet each other. He used to admire my on the Facebook. He was on the Facebook for some time and always encouraged me to write. What I remember most is we used to sit in the ICU because the patient was not doing good. And we used to be very stressed out. He used to come and give some tips, used to give some advice, and the patient sometimes used to do better. There were very seldom occasions when he lost temper, but when he lost temper, his admonition was severe enough. But all same, I would say he was a man who colonized our heart. He will always remain in our heart for as a good person and a good teacher. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I invite Dr. Sudhanshu Bhattacharya to kindly speak a few words. So Bhattacharya, you are there, sir?
Yeah.
Please go ahead, sir.
First, let me convey my condolences to the family. I am extremely pained to see that we are losing the, in true sense, a guru. His accidentally, his name is also Guru Kumar. So, you know, to miss a guru for a lifetime is painful. I missed a guru, Johnson, Dudley Johnson, a couple of years back. Now I'm missing another guru. I have learned a lot of things from Dr. Parulkar. And though we had differences and love affair and everything with him,
can't hear.
We had a lot of love affair and differences with him, but ultimately he had a lot of confidence in me that he gave his heart to me for bypass surgery. So I did his bypass surgery one day, and he would tell in the ICU that no, you can't touch that central line. Dr. Bhattacharya will come and remove it. That drainage tube, no, don't, you don't dare to touch it. No, Dr. Bhattacharya will remove the drainage tube. So from the stitches to everything, to from removing of oils, cannulis, everything was done. Because this man had seen plenty of complications, and we have also seen plenty of complications of knots in any of these catheters and all that thing. He had fair amount of confidence at the end of his life on me that he would, he allowed me to do that. And the mediator at that time was Dr. K.R. Shetty. And finally, of course, I operated on Dr. K.R. Shetty also. But I would say that I got a tremendous chance from the God to give my Guru Dakshina to the Guru again. And I only realized that we can prolong life, but we can't prolong the mental state of the man. I'm extremely hurt also to hear that he doesn't meet anybody, this, that. Though I talked to Amla on and off, but we were very pained in the last part that we could not see him or we could not talk to him. I pray to God for his soul to rest in peace. There would not be a teacher like this again. Just remembering that ICU, he would come at 2 o'clock at night after finishing some dinner party or something and give us half a bottle of whiskey that you finish it, rest, you finish, you guys finish it. Because he used to see us awake whole night with these patients in the ICU. And from that time onwards, I had an associate with him all the time. And But it was a surprise that at 2 o'clock he can pass on a whiskey bottle to us, half a whiskey bottle to us, and say that aap log lo and relax. You people are working very hard. It's a surprise, and I don't know how many can really come to an institution, teaching institution, and pass on a bottle there. I really don't know. But we had witnessed all these things, and I enjoyed working. I would remember him whole lifelong. And I think there will be many, many students also who would remember me like this. And his humor was tremendous. But at the same time, I had seen him, people would be coming crying from Dr. P.K. Sen's office, but then they would meet Dr. G.V. Parulkar and get solace. And he would give solace to everybody. So there were some good, extremely touching points about this man, that he would never truly disappoint you very much. But we had been on his good books and bad books both, but whatever said and done, when he said that, Bhattacharya, why don't you do my surgery, I think he wiped off everything and gave me a God-given chance to give him the Guru Dakshina. I feel let his soul rest in peace. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I'd like to invite Dr. Anil Tendulkar, please.
Dr. Parulkar was not just father of cardiac surgery, but a father figure to all of us. He will fire us for mistakes on operation table, left, right, center, which chase bad words from Marathi, starting with B. But believe me, moment the case is over, forget the outside world. Even the surgeon lounge will not know what was the complication that took place in the operation theater. He will not utter a single word about that complication. To the outside world, his relations with Dr. Pandey were always absolutely classical relations between any two cardiac surgical units, starting from Denton Cooley and DeBakey. But to an outsider, for a stranger, if he asks a question about Dr. Pandey in a little taunting manner, he will show utter surprise. He say, "Is it? Our relations are bad? I didn't know that." So to outside world, he always will present as a unit together, working together. One aspect of Dr. Parulkar which touched me was his clinical judgment. As a first exposure to Dr. Parulkar was in second MBBS when we attended his general surgery clinics. And mind you, that general surgery batch of 8 or 10 students, along with that batch, other batches, senior batches, junior batches, batches coming from Tata, there were some 40, 50 odd students. Dr. Parulkar took a clinic of swelling on the outer border of the eyebrow by asking students just 3 questions. And that was the real genuine clinic. I'll end my talk with one more clinical case. As everybody is narrating, Dr. Parulkar taking rounds at night. He once came at night at around 11:30, 12, and he asked me what is the list for tomorrow. And I showed him double wall for tomorrow, story of 1978-79. He saw the X-ray in the dim light of the ward in oblique manner, and he said, this is not double wall. This can be anything in the world but double wall. Dr. Bhattacharya and everybody cursed sir next day morning when they were told double wall is cancelled. That case underwent cardiac cath and was a case of truncus arteriosus. So his clinical sense, his operative judgment on operation table was just phenomenal. Just we all try our best to emulate those techniques. He once held a hand of a patient of DU perforation, and that patient was absolutely sweating. And he said, this is not DU perforation or gastritis. This is inferior infarct. And indeed, it turned out to be inferior infarct. So we have not just lost a fatherly figure, but we have really lost a father who looked after us in every aspect of the nurturing of a resident. Sir, Baba will miss you forever. Thank you.
I can invite Dr. Ratna Magotra, please.
Yes. First of all, my apologies. My camera is not working. I hope I'm audible.
No problem. Please go ahead, madam. Yes.
It was with great sadness when Anil Kachwajan called me and told me about passing away of doctor. Sadness was even more acutely felt because in the times that we live, we could not be present even for his last rites. I do not claim to know Dr. Parulkar as well as Dr. Tendulkar and other people because I never trained under him. But although I was not working at KEM or training at KEM, I felt his larger than life presence in whatever circles we moved in as postgraduate students those days. And it was in 1984 that I went to KEM and came to know him better. He was at time working as a dean. As all of the speakers have described and more will describe his leadership qualities, his clinical acumen, his surgical and research work were outstanding, absolutely outstanding. And whatever position he held, he performed with great aplomb and with great style. And that was true for the association also. I think his life was totally dedicated to cardiovascular surgery. Department of Cardiovascular Thoracic Surgery at the KM Hospital, his students and his patients in that order. His reputation as a great teacher is well known to everyone, and so many have described, like Tendulkar described, his clinical skills. And I thought that as a medical administrator also he excelled, and that also did not keep him away from the department that he had loved and nurtured. He would often drop in and even scrub for an occasional case. This gave him a little time away from the administrative responsibilities. And it was during this time that he would relate so many stories and clinical experiences. And he was a great storyteller, something which Anil Tendulkar has got that quality in him. I felt that Dr. Parulkar was a leader in true sense, whatever position in the association as a cardiovascular surgeon he took, he performed with great involvement. He was totally committed to it. And I may not be wrong if I say that he was solely responsible for putting the KEM hospital and cardiovascular department on the global map. Wherever you went, and if one said that we are from KEM or you're from GBP center, you got an easy passage through. I know there are many other speakers and they will be speaking about different aspects of his multifaceted personality. There's one quality that I found very distinct and will like to mention that. He connected extremely well with everyone across the board. And as he became higher and higher in his position, he retained his popularity, which is so unique because most people who reach top, they either become aloof or even run the risk of becoming unpopular because of their arrogance or whatever. Dr. Parulkar kept that connect with common man, his patients, his students, especially the students. He was extremely persuasive, very possessive, very protective about his students. And he followed their careers long after they had left and were even heading their own independent units. He was filled with immense pride and pleasure whenever they excelled in whatever field, and he celebrated that his own success. I feel privileged to pay my respects to Dr. G.P. Parulkar as a part of his CBTS family. And maybe we shall meet physically in better times to celebrate his life, to remember him. And really, such people don't go away. They live with us. I extend my heartfelt condolences to the large community of cardiovascular surgeons, his students, to Amla, Vivek, Raju, and their families. This is our shared hour of grief. Om Shanti.
Thank you. Thank you, madam. I would like to invite Dr. Suresh Joshi, please. Dr. Joshi, are there? Dr. Suresh Joshi, you are there, sir. As he joins, I would like to invite Dr. Anil Patwardhan, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Hiremat. You can hear me?
Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Yeah. So I began my training in cardiac surgery in 1979 under Dr. Chaukar. So here across 4 kilometers away at KM Hospital was Dr. Parulkar, my teacher's teacher. So we had the opportunity to learn from him. We pestered him for clinics and he readily obliged. The brilliant, demanding clinician that he was showed us how dissatisfied he was with our knowledge and efforts. That gave us the impetus to put in hard work and efforts to excel so that one day we would be blessed with a pat on the back. His lectures used to be informative and educative with the latest information in those days when there was no internet. It is said that a teacher affects eternity. No one can tell where the influence will end. So Dr. Parulkar lives through his students even if he's not with us today. And he will continue to bless us. My deepest heartfelt condolences to the family. So my deepest heartfelt condolences to the family. And we will miss him all our lives. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Suresh Joshi, you are there, sir?
Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you. Please go ahead, sir.
Yeah, I can't. My video is not working. Anyway, can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. Please go ahead, sir.
Well, it's a very emotional moment for me because obviously all of us, we have been so closely associated with him till very recently, till he was almost invalid and being at home. And I wish to convey my condolences to Amla, Raju, Vivek, and everybody. I was really very close to him, and I must have been the only person who has received the maximum amount of choices, curses, not only in the beginning, but till as recently as just about a year or two. And he often used to visit my operation theater when he had one of his patients getting operated by me. I'm going to really miss him. And I'm 100% sure God will give him the best place in the heaven. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Jagdish Kandepakar, sir. So kindly unmute yourself, sir.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Yeah.
My sincere condolences to Raju, Vivek, and Amla. This takes me back to my very pre-medical days. I was just walking out of the Goa Medical College Hospital, and I saw a dashing, tall, well-dressed person entering the campus. He straight charged at me and grabbed my hand and asked me, "Show me your library." So I got confused. I said, "What?" I said, "I want to see your library." I said, "I'm not a student here." "What?" He said, "You're not a student, and what the hell are you doing here?" So he grabbed me around and said, "Well, I'll show you your library. Don't tell me that you're not a student." I said, "I've just finished my first year science." "Oh," he said, "then what do you want to become?" "I want to become heart surgeon." He said, "What the hell, you're not even joined medicine, and what the hell you're trying to tell me that you want to become a heart surgeon? Why the hell do you want to become a heart surgeon?" The news of heart transplant by Christian Barnard and PKSN was doing round at that time. And so I told him that I'm just impressed by this news of heart transplant by Christian Barnard and Dr. PKSN. So he said, "If you want to become a cardiac surgeon, forget Christian Barnard. You have to remember Dr. G.B. Purulkar." So in my juvenile stupidity, innocence, ignorance, whatever it is, I asked him, "Who is this G.B. Purulkar?" He said, "This is G.B. Purulkar standing in front of you. It's me. You remember G.B. Purulkar always. That's all." And how prophetic it was. Yes, I remembered him then, and I'm now remembering him always throughout my life. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I would like to invite Dr. Vivek Jawali, please.
Thank you, IICTS. On behalf of my alumni association, I express our gratitude that you held this function today. Dr. Tendulkar informed me in the morning, and the whole day has been clouded with sir's memory. I'm very emotional today. Sir's greatest quality as a teacher was to stand on the left side patiently and teach you the operation. When I was in KEM, in a quick succession, Dr. Pandey and Dr. Bhattacharya left to private practice. And can you hear me? Okay. They left for...
Please go ahead, sir.
Oh, in this picture, you can see Dr. Parulkar and Dr. Dudley, both of them. Dudley, of course, I never worked with him, but he came so often to Bangalore, helped me. Dr. Parulkar also helped me a lot to build Jayadeva. And these two people left a deep impression on me as true gurus. Coming back to the greatest quality of sir was to stand on the opposite side patiently. I don't know how many of us as teachers have that patience. Because these two stalwarts left KEM, the boys that we were working at that time, like me, Bala, etc., got so much to operate, and we got so much of experience, and sir patiently pardoned all our mistakes. By the time, and also we became great leaders and managers. Whether the water supply didn't come that day, whether electricity, whether there was a problem, blood bank officer had a problem, or a technician for doing potassium or sodium was not there, a X-ray technician was not there. These were not the complaints that we were supposed to tell. We were supposed to go get it, fix it. By the time I left KEM and came to Bangalore, I was a go-get-it man. I could have been put into Congo, Zaire, Chad, anywhere in the world, and I would have built a heart institute. That was the greatest gift Dr. Parulkar gave to all of us, whether it's me, Bala, Suresh, Tendulkar. He made us go-get guys. He was a fun guy. Look at his picture. And he made us, you know, not be serious. He had ancestral home at Alibag. The key was always for asking. He'd go there, have fun. My wife could never understand Sadhana, that with his poker face, he was actually joking. And we had a lot of problems, and I had a lot of problem convincing her that I had never such girlfriends that Parulkar told her about. So I have such fantastic memories of him. He was very proud of his students. So many times he came to Bangalore. My team remembers him so fondly. He helped me so much. Every time I came to Bangalore, I would take him to the health minister, chief minister, and in his inimitable style, he could brainwash them to sanction money. And Dr. Chinnaya, who was the director of that institute, was so grateful to him for having come there so many times. When we built Wokhart, sir retired, and I used all my persuasion, and I got him onto the board of Wokhart, board of directors. I was also on the board. And we had such good times in the board, and it brought me so close to him later on in his post-retirement days. I remember sir a lot, and sir was a great combination of so many things, but the most important, how a teacher should be, a boss should be, and how he can create great students, and how he can keep in touch with them, watch their growth on social media. Anytime I made a comment, sir would come on the social media and comment on my comments and pat my back everywhere. He is missed. Rest in peace, sir.
Thank you, sir. I would like to invite Dr. K.R. Balakrishnan, please.
Yeah, at the outset, my sincere condolences to Amla and Raju. I don't know if they remember us or not. They are kids when we were training. As every one of his students has said, he's the best teacher you could ever dream of having, not only for theory, but for actual practical surgery. And as I concur with Vivek, I never had the patience that he had, you know, helping. We were all 24, 23 years old at that time to struggle to just take stitches. I mean, he would stay with you right till the end. And he had this very wonderful habit. While he's assisting you as the first assistant, he'll curse the second assistant to let you know what mistakes you're making. And in choices, Marathi Goyle is. In fact, I still remember Marathi, and I can speak it fairly well to a large extent because of having been initiated in the operating room by choices Goyle, as Tendulkar said. And two incidences I would like to share. The first one was the world's leading surgeons used to come to KEM and Bombay at the time. I mean, virtually the who's who of cardiac surgery, Cooley, Hans Boss from Hanover, Waldhausen, the whole who's who. And I particularly remember one instance I wish to share with you. John Waldhausen, you know, the co-optation Nayuda of fame, he actually had dinner in the RMO quarters in the first floor. I don't know whether today we would ever have the courage to organize a dinner in that kind of a setting. Those days, I'm talking about 1982. And I remember this day in particular because that day I had done a mitral valve replacement and that patient died on the operating table. I was 24 years old. I wanted to run home to my mother who was in Tangier about 2000 miles away. Of course, it's not easy for, I mean, all of you are surgeons. You'll remember your first death. It's a shattering event. And the routine in KM was the next morning, whoever is the blood bank registrar has to find out the blood position and call him, and he will tell you who goes to operate what. And I happened to be in charge of the blood bank at the time. And next morning I called him up at 8 o'clock and he said, ask Tendulkar to go and do the tetralogy and you do the mitral. And this was an elderly lady, what we call in Bombay, cockadoo mitral, you know, three times previous mitral valvotomy, left atrial thrombus, you know. The last thing I wanted was to touch one more mitral. I wanted to go home to mother. And I said, no, I don't want to do it. And he taught me the most important lesson of my surgical life. He said, you idiot, he used the word bharwa. You think cardiac surgery is all glamour, walking around with three buttons undone. I mean, he was, I think, referring to Dr. Pandey. And walking around, it is having to face death, having to face complications, having to face the family, and still have the courage to go and operate the next day. That is what this specialty is. Don't think it's all glamour. And I think it's the most important lesson you can ever learn. To some extent, it's like Bhagavad Gita. You can only do your best. And on a lighter note, the other anecdote I would wish to share is in those days, our salary was 400 rupees a month, or some such miserable amount. And all these big conferences were held in Taj in the Gateway of India. So we never had the money to pay for the conference registration. And we are always perpetually hungry. And so we didn't have the money to have the dinner, which was served in the banquet. And Jimmy was perceptive enough to know what you're doing. So he'll call us and say, I'll teach you an ice cream trick. Wait for half an hour till the first batch has finished dinner and they're going to the dessert. So you'll walk along with them, take a plate and start with the ice cream and work your way back. I mean, that was before these days they flashed those cards and all that. I remember this with great fondness because he always took care of his postgraduates for the rest of his life. And I was in touch with him till a few months ago when, has happened, as Vivek said. Whatever we are today, whatever little we've accomplished in life, I think we owe it entirely to him. And I wish we are able to teach our residents 100th of what he taught us. May his soul rest in peace.
Thank you, sir. I'd like to invite Dr. C. Krishna, please.
Thank you very much. First of all, I convey my condolences to the family. I have a very interesting episode when I first met GB sir. Way back in 1985, I was a young aspiring cardiac surgeon doing Bharat Darshan to get a seat in some institution to learn cardiac surgery. And I was new to Bombay. I did not know how many colleges were there and how many colleges were offering MCH. So I had just taken an application form and put KEM on the institution column, and then I was called for an interview. And this was in the municipal corporation, and there was a huge committee, and somebody asked me, "Why you have applied only for KEM? What about the other colleges?" First of all, I did not know that there were other three other colleges offering MCH in Bombay. So I said, "No, sir, I want only KU." So that was the first time when GB sir said, "See, this boy wants only KEM." He was so thrilled with that answer of mine. And that was the first time I met him. Subsequently, I did not get selected. I went again, doing my Bharat Darshan, spent a couple of months in Vellore, and somehow I got an opportunity to come back to KEM, and perhaps I was probably one of the last of his direct students. He was my thesis guide at that time, and of course Tendulkar and Kanda Parker were my mentors, and Suresh Joshi. So that was my first contact with Dr. Parulkar. And subsequently, we have had a lot of this thing, and all my seniors have said he would stand, come to the theater and stand across and then guide us and many, many things. And he used to take fantastic clinics. And the one great thing that he has done to his students is he was very, very encouraging to send all his students to the nook and corners of this country to start on our own. And that is what we are very grateful for. And we can always be grateful for such a wonderful teacher. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I'm Dr. Hema Kulkarni. I'm the only cardiologist here, perhaps. I just simply cannot imagine that Dr. Parulkar is doing. My condolences to all his families. I remember there's so many things we can talk about him, really. But I'll give you only a few instances. One of them was that we were supposed to go to cardiac surgery OPDs when we were lecturers. And I must say that I learned as much cardiology from him as much I learned from my teachers in cardiology. Second important thing is, you know, earlier we used to have common meetings with cardiac surgeons and cardiologists. And he really looked after us. I mean, he used to give us at least 2 cars to roam all over the city, wherever we were. So that was one more thing. And third thing I remember is that we used to go to his house every year, and he used to get all of them drunk. And I remember we used to have pav bhaji or pav kema and a cake. So thanks a lot, Dr. Parulkar, for whatever you did for us. And may his soul rest in peace.
Thank you, madam. Dr. Tushar Shah, you are back, sir. As he joins, I would invite Dr. Shivanayar, sir. Dr. Shivanayar, you are there? Yeah, please go ahead,
sir. Yeah, thank you, Hiramat. I would like to begin by giving my deepest condolences to Dr. Raju and Dr. Amla, and to say that we'll really miss Dr. G.B. Parulkar, sir, for our whole lives. So I must begin by saying that when I was doing my MS, I first heard this tale about KEM Hospital. I was doing my MS in PGI Chandigarh, and one of my seniors told me that if you want to become a cardiac surgeon, you need to do your MCH in KEM Hospital. So a few weeks after passing my exam, I took a train and I reached KEM Hospital. I got up at Enfilston Road Station and walked to the KEM Hospital and to the Dean's office to Dr. Parulkar, who didn't know me and I had never met him before. And I went inside the room. He was most gracious. And I said, I want to do my MCH here in KEM Hospital. So he told me there is no position available nowadays now at the moment. And what are your other plans? So I said, I'm joining in CMC Vellore as a non-PG registrar. And then I will see next what to do. So he said, oh, that's a good institution. You please carry on. And that was the conversation. It was limited to a few minutes, but he was very encouraging. To my utter surprise, 2 months later, while I was working in CMC Vellore, on a Friday evening, I get a telegram to say that there is a seat fallen vacant. And the last day for registration in the university is the Monday following. And please come and join if you can. I was absolutely astounded that he remembered my desire to join KEM Hospital and 2 months later took the effort to send me a telegram from the exalted position that he held at that time. And so the rest is providence that I could come and join KEM Hospital, and that has changed my life. And I have to agree with what I had heard, that it made me a cardiac surgeon. What I would like to very specifically say is that he was a very generous spirit in his praise, in his affection. And I always recall the very first paper that I presented was in the Bangalore meeting in 1987. And Dr. Solomon Victor was on the chair and he asked me a question, which I must have given a very, you know, hesitant reply. But at the end of the presentation, Dr. G.V. Parulkar came up to me and gave me such a thumping on my back and made it sound as if I had given the best presentation that was ever possible to do in this whole world. So that was the wonderful quality that he had, that for a person like me, who was just a second year resident, making my first presentation in a cardiac surgery conference, he made me feel so confident about myself. So I think that it's a G.V. Parulkar School of Cardiovascular Surgery, which, like Bolton Lilly had the School of Surgery, I think for India, Dr. G.V. Parulkar School of Surgery, which was taken forward by stalwarts like Dr. Tendulkar, Dr. Khandepalkar, in the same spirit that he had inculcated in them to all the trainees subsequently. I really believe that he will be remembered. And when somebody is remembered as much as he is, he will always be living within us and with us. And I hope the association can take his memory forward in a very meaningful manner. My deepest condolences once again. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Tushar Shah, you're there, sir. Dr. Sukumar Mehta is there.
I'm there. Hi.
Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Okay. I'm very sad to have lost my guru. And I remember Dr. Sri Krishna and I were his last students and he had signed our dissertations. Just like a very pleasant experience Dr. Shiv Kumar Nair had about his admission process, I also had a very good experience. I had appeared in the interview and he had liked my credentials coming from Gujarat. But at the time, the rules prevailing in Maharashtra were not in favor of people coming from other states. And the only way I could have got admission to KEM was to go to the court and challenge the rule. So I had met him in the morning and said, sir, this is the way I can get admission under your guidance in your college. But you have been so sympathetic and I'm hesitant because you might feel bad if I challenge your municipal corporation and all that. But then he assured me that no, he will not hold it against me. And he will be pleased if the court gives me admission, court gives me the order. And fortunately for me, the lady judge Sujata Manohar in those days, she passed an interim order and I went to Parulkar Sahab and he took me as a student. But then as many of my preceding speakers have said, his sense of humor was so much that every time he used to come from his dean's office to the CVTC department, he used to scare me because I was working only on an interim order of the High Court. So he used to scare me that Mehta, I heard your case is coming up for hearing next week. And what will you do if the admission is canceled? So for two or three times, I got scared. And then I inquired with my lawyer. And one day I told him, I said, no, sir, my case is not coming up for next 3 years. And now please don't scare me like this. And I was a beneficiary of his ancestral house at Alibag to enjoy a picnic. In Diwali days, when I was from Gujarat and I could not go home to the family, I remember he once called me on the landline and said, Mehta, what are you doing? I said, sir, I'm in the LIC. I see you doing duty. He said, please come to my bungalow, Dean's bungalow. And when I reached there, he gave me almost 4 or 5 kilograms of sweets to take to the department and share with everybody. May his soul rest in eternal peace.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Tushar, sir, you are there, sir, but Dr. Anvay Mule is there.
Yes.
Dr. Anvay Mule, please. Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Actually, I was probably the last student. When I finished my NCH, Dr. G.V. Parulkar retired as a dean and as a head of the department. What I've seen Dr. G.V. Parulkar is through my teachers, Dr. Anil Tendulkar, Suresh Joshi. But sometimes he used to come to our operation theater and sit in a corner without doing anything. And then we came to know that he wanted to avoid some meeting or something. And that time cell phones were not there. But he used to sit in a corner. But at the same time, he could see and understand what operation steps and what mistakes we are doing. And used to shout from that corner also. The first incidents when I was came across with him was we were on the rounds, our routine rounds in the ward and ICU. And he came with Russian cardiac surgeons and then came to a round and joined the round with him and said, this is the patient of, he's patient of what? So Dr. Anil Tendulkar said that he is a patient of aortic aneurysm. So he caught hold of Shiv Kumar Nair and said that this is the junior most resident of ours and he has done this aortic aneurysm yesterday and today the patient is extubated and he is doing fine. So he has so much confidence and so much praise he used to have for his unit and his student. But that was really amazing. The next time he called was when we did a first heart transplant of Maharashtra or Mumbai, the successful first heart transplant. Of course, after 43 years, 46 years. And then he personally called me to tell me, to give me congratulations. I know Amla and Vivek very well. And I have my heartfelt condolences. And thank you. We are lost a great teacher. But in all of us, his work will continue. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Before I start my question and answers, anybody else in the audience, sir, would like to share their experiences of Dr. Parulkar?
Dr. Hiramas, I'm Tushar. Yeah. Can I?
Please go ahead, sir. Thank you. You're back. Please go ahead, sir.
I met Dr. Parulkar in 1980 after finishing general surgery. And I went to him with a recommendation letter from an onco surgeon, Dr. D.D. Patel. Dr. Parulkar read this and he said, you have come to a wrong place. You should become an onco surgeon. I'll send you to Tata. I said, I want to become a cardiac surgeon. That is why I'm here. The next question that he asked me was, have you seen any cardiac surgery? I said, no. Third question, did you meet any other cardiac surgery department? Have you been there? I said, no, this is the only department. He said, if you are so keen to become a cardiac surgeon, join from tomorrow. Those were the days when there were no exams, just an application. From then on, he has been extremely supportive to me in good times and bad times. He taught me basics of cardiac surgery. He helped me in learning basic closures of ASD, valve replacements. In 1983, when I passed MCH, he called me and said, what are your plans? I told him, I'm going back to Gujarat. He said, don't tell me, you are a fool. You cannot go to Gujarat and do general surgery. I said, no, I'll do cardiac surgery. He said, you are a bigger fool. With this much little training, how can you do cardiac surgery in Gujarat? I explained to him that it is not possible. circumstances will not permit me to stay here longer, any longer. Immediately, he understood my heart. He said, don't be foolish. Don't stay in Bombay. Go back to Gujarat. Start cardiac surgery. And that is how in 84, the first open heart surgery was done by us. Dr. Parulkar was supposed to help me, but because of Mrs. Indira Gandhi's assassination, he could not come. He was asked by Commissioner, Bombay Municipal Commissioner, to stay back in Mumbai. We did our first open mitral valvotomy, first open heart surgery in Gujarat. For 7 days continuously, he kept a track of what is happening to the patient. And every day he encouraged me. This is how surgery, cardiac surgery in Gujarat started. He wrote a very, very encouraging letter to me, congratulating me and all team members and wishing me the best luck. The story does not end here. After 2 years, once he called me up and said, are your problems of family and others over? I said, more or less. Immediately he said, now for 6 months, you are going to US, 3 months with Denton Cooley and 3 months with Dr. Dibaki as an observer. I'm going to arrange everything for you. And he did it. It was a God's given gift. Dr. Parulkar took so keen interest to see that I go there as an observer, spend good time and see good surgery. Subsequently, we have been in touch. I will really, really miss him. What a piece of work a man was. How infinite in his faculties. How noble in his gestures. How precious his words and actions were. I shall always miss him. Thank you very much, Dr. Hiramath and IECTS. I pray God that God grants him an eternal peace and my heartfelt condolences to all the family members. Thank you.
Thank you. Dr. Jilay Singh Mirwal is there, our senior vice president. Sir, are you there on board, sir?
Yeah, Hiramath.
Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Thank you, Hiramath. My first major interaction with Professor Parulkar was when he came as an expert in Sanjay Gandhi Institute of Medical Sciences in Lucknow as an expert, where I had applied for the assistant professor job. And I was so impressed the way he interacted, discussed with me, not only the things which normally would be asked in the interview, but basically related to cardiac surgery and the future, what could expect from in cardiac surgery and how one could progress. I didn't join as the faculty, and it was about 6 or 7 months later, he met me in one of the meetings and asked me, you didn't join? I said, yes, sir, I didn't join because I think I still am a student. And when you become assistant professor, you actually become a teacher. And I think I still need a few years to train myself as a student before I can join as a faculty. So he laughed and he said, well, we as cardiac surgeons, you will remain as a student throughout your life because you keep learning at every stage. So even when you become very senior, you still keep learning. But he was quite impressed by my answer. Before that, my only interaction with him had been when I listened to him as a speaker, as a chairperson. And after that, we have been meeting in various conferences, and it was so interesting to listen to his talks and to the way he used to discuss the things as a chairperson. And the most important thing was that he made you so comfortable for whatever you want to discuss with him, whether it is related to cardiac surgery or to your career, to your future plans. And you always feel comfortable whenever you discuss with him. So I never had the chance to work with him or get trained by him, but I knew a lot of people who did MCH from KEM, and I used to talk to him, and I was so impressed when they used to talk about him, how he used to teach and train. And one will always feel that he certainly is a great teacher, a great human being. And all of us know that he is known as a world over from India. So we all are definitely going to miss him. And on behalf of the association and myself, my heartfelt condolences to the whole family. May his soul rest in peace. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'd like to invite Dr. Lokesh Sajja, Junior Vice President of our association, to tell us a few words.
Thank you very much. At the outset, I give my condolences, heartfelt condolences to Professor Guru Parulkar's family. I describe briefly three interactions I had with him when he was in jail. Because I am not a student of him. First time I met him, when I went to Chennai airport to receive him to give a lecture, annual oration at Jipman. So he was invited as a guest to deliver the oration. So I was waiting to the Patras department as a junior resident in general surgery. So I went to the airport and received him, and I accompanied him from Chennai airport to Pondicherry, Jipman. During the 3-hour period, he was telling me about all the cardiac surgery, that what is the greatness and all those things. And he described so many stories during the period, how the cardiac surgery happened. And he takes pride in his students. So during that time, he told me, one of my students who has been the embolectomy of femoral artery, and after that we found that the histopathological, it is a myxoma. And then we did again the cardiac surgery. And he mentioned that K.R. Balakrishnan was the resident who has done that thing, and he takes great pride in the achievement of his students. And he also told me during that same period, I was a general surgery resident, and his unit now attracts the brightest from all over India. So then he mentioned Dr. Bala was from All India Institute, Dr. Shivanayar from PGI, they all were this. And he is such a warm person, and he would be, he will teach and explain anybody. Though I am a general surgery resident, that time I would become a cardiac surgeon, but I had interest from the beginning as an undergraduate. So I know these people, at least heard of them. So it would be, and he gave a wonderful lecture that made an impression on me on 25 years of open heart surgery. That was the title of his annual lecture that he gave Jipman. Another incident was when I applied for the membership. I wanted to apply for the membership of American Association of Cardiothoracic Surgeons. I knew Dr. Parulkar was a member, Graham Travel Fellowship member. I was under the impression that all the Graham Travel can sponsor me for the membership. Then I went to Bombay and met him in the hospital. Then he said, only members can sponsor you, and from India, Dr. K.M. Chiran is the first person probably you have to approach. He's a very generous man. He helps anybody who is coming to this team. That is my interaction. And on behalf of the Indian Association of Cardiovascular Surgeons, myself, I express my heartfelt condolences to the family.
Thank you, sir. I have one question for his family members. Either Dr. Raju or Amla can answer this. As it is said, you can move a soldier from the country, but you can never move the country out of his heart. I think the same goes with Dr. Parulkar and KEM. What did Dr. Parulkar do after his retirement? You need to unmute yourself.
Daddy never retired. To tell you the truth, Daddy after retirement joined WOCHARD, and till 2 years back, when he had little medical problem, he was working throughout in WOCHARD. He was going in the mornings there. Evening, he used to go to the consulting rooms. So Daddy never really retired. In fact, I was going to tell you just now this, that he enjoyed and he really loved all the cardiac department. And we used to always tease him that probably cardiac is your first family. We are the second one. Because he used to, as Anil and everybody said, he used to go at night for the rounds. He used to, after dinner, he would tell us and mommy, oh, I'm going checking on the patients, come back again. He really, really loved cardiac and also whatever he was doing later on.
Standard instruction was, if you get a phone from my home, yeah, tell them the patient is very serious.
You have not told about his batatwada and the tiffin, which all of you ate, and he only had the batatwadas. So he was very comfortable with everybody in cardiac department. So that's it.
If you had to describe Dr. Parulkar in one word, what it would be?
You are asking us?
For everybody, sir. Everybody, madam. Dr. Nulkar, you can take the answer.
One word, unfair. As Dr. Parulkar would have liked it, 1,000 words you should allow. Then only then I can describe. But as everybody said, love for the department, love for cardiac surgery, love for students, these three qualities of him stood absolutely with him all the time.
What were Dr. Parulkar's interest outside cardiac surgery, sir?
Food.
Can I say something?
Yeah, please, man.
You know, once he came for a party.
Hema, we are holding our breath.
Three different places. And three times he had different suits. So I was just shocked. But this is what he could do.
His love for food was immense. Madam Suman Parulkar will send a very healthy dabba consisting of cucumbers and carrots and whatnot. He will insist this is eaten by the students, and whatever students is to order from downstairs Sayadri, chicken makhan wala, paratha, he will eat it. And he will tell all the students that please finish that dabba. Even a small piece remains, I am finished at home. So food, that is all true for Sagittarians, I think. I think Chaukar sir wants to say something.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Please go ahead, sir.
His other hobby was to pull anybody's leg. I remember I.M. Rao was with his wife, and Denton Cooley was there at the conference, and Dr. Parulkar and Dr. I.M. Rao and Denton Cooley were chatting, and he says, yes, this is. So I.M. Rao said, meet Mrs. Rao. So he looked so shocked, and he acted so very well as being shocked. He said, "Arre, but last time I met, it was some other lady with you. Which one is the I.M. Rao's wife?" No, I.M. Rao didn't know what to say.
But just like one speaker now told that his favorite was to pull legs, and classic was if some junior, some lecturer, he will introduce to a stranger as first year resident, and he has done all this operation. Once he walked into the operation theater around 1 o'clock, and 1 o'clock is a time at KEM when the first two open hearts are getting shifted out and next two are being brought in. So he asked, "Dr. Tendulkar, are you doing any operation today?" That was typical of him to ask. So very proudly I told him, "Sir, already we have finished two and two are already induced." So now I paused. "Only four open hearts? You are relaxing." So the person with whom he had walked in used to do four open hearts in a month. So that person started shivering and started telling Dr. Parulkar that, nahi, sir, aisa gussa mat kijiye. He's a very nice boy. He said, "Don't take his side. They are all relaxing because I am away." So that was typical of him.
So, to that question, if he was not the cardiac surgeon, what would he be? I would say the greatest actor on earth, on screen or stage.
So now I know where Dr. Chaukar and Dr. Manke have learnt pulling the legs.
Sir, if Dr. Suresh Joshi was the best student, who was the second best student, sir?
Loved, second best or first best, I don't know, but person he loved from his bottom of his heart was Dr. A.P. Chaukar.
A.P. Chaukar, okay.
There's absolutely no discussion. We won't come close second.
Yeah. question to Dr. Ambala. How did he balance family life versus profession?
I should say that my...
Ambala, the idea is he's trying to get tips from you how to do it.
No, but then his missus has to come. Mrs. Hiremath has to come because it was mummy who saw to it that he was there for us all the time whenever we needed. But otherwise, mummy was the pillar of the family thing. Daddy could continue to do his cardiac work without, I mean, I'm not saying that we are good, but whatever we are, me and Raju, are because mummy saw to it that daddy was there for us, but at the same time, she instilled whatever qualities we have. So it was...
It's like the two sides of the same coin, right, Amla?
Yeah, absolutely.
Two sides of the same coin.
Two sides of the same coin. Absolutely.
So, they were very complimentary because... If both had done what he had tried to do, I don't know where Amla and I would be. But because one of them decided to be the support of the family and one was the support for the cardiac surgery.
Cardiac family.
This is where we are. So his legacy is very, very, very strong for us. Thank you.
Sir, why is that the son, neither the daughter, become a cardiac surgeon seeing his father's, setting his father's legacy?
Mine was a total coincidence. I would have become a cardiac surgeon, but for Dr. Pardhanani. I was actually doing my internship, and one of the residents from the urology program went to USA suddenly, and there was a vacancy at a house staff position. I went for a 3-month locum, and Dr. Pardhanani convinced my dad. And I'm telling you, urology has its own exciting, series of surgeries. And in 3 months, I was converted.
Baba was and pissed off?
Pardon?
Baba must be pissed off.
No, so actually that's what I wanted to say. His strength was that
humor.
He actually,
humor.
He pissed off. Yeah, the P was silent though. So he was pissed off. So he actually talked, he came and talked to me and said, you know what, Raju, your personality, your ability to do diverse things, this is a better career than cardiac surgery, because cardiac surgery you have to devote yourself 24/7, and with multiple other things that were going on that I was doing at that time, acting, music, whatever, I decided, I've acted in the play with Anil, right, Anil, you remember
very much,
Do Jeevanchi Ekata,
yeah
the play was Do Jeevanchi Ekata.
Now, the problem with Raju is to buyer the entire 3-act play, everybody's dialogues in 2 days, 3 days. And then he used to tell us, he used to, while acting in the drama, he used to change the dialogues a little bit. He used to say, no. That is not the correct.
Can I say a word?
Sure, sir.
Yeah.
Well, Raju, I'm glad you brought this subject up. Raju was actually a feather in my cap. I could get him and keep him there. And he's one of the outstanding product of the urology department. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yes, Hiremath, any more questions?
Yeah, next is to Dr. Chaukar, sir. What were his areas of interest and strength in cardiac surgery? Any favorites?
Well, he was very much in pediatric cardiac surgery. And then he was great in research and used to spend a huge amount of time in dog lab and tell us all. The so-called right atrium to pulmonary artery shunt, we were sitting and discussing, and we thought that it can be done, and that is what he did it in dog lab. And one of the surgeons had come from South with Yule's anomalous case, and he said, why don't you try that? And apparently, I think he did that. But now that Amla brought up the subject of Mrs. Parulkar running the family, I know that he used to act so well about being scared of Mrs. Parulkar that following the transplant, which we had not slept for about more than 36 hours, he had come to my house. My quarters were in the CVTC 4th fourth floor. And he, Dr. Samsi, myself, and one more person, Machine Joshi, we were sitting. And then we were so tired, so we had a beer. But Dr. Parulkar had probably half a glass of beer. And then he said, my God, I have to go home. And Mrs. Parulkar is at home. So it will smell, no? He said, yes, beer will always smell. So he said,
toothpaste.
So I said, yes. So I gave him a Colgate toothpaste and half of it. I said, GB, next time I'll pay for your beer, but never for your toothpaste. So that's how he acted and then went away.
Thank you, sir. In fact, I would like to thank all the members of the association, family members, and colleagues for joining this panelist meeting. I request our president, Dr. Krishna S. Iyer, to give the concluding remarks.
Thank you all for joining. Especially, I'd like to thank Dr. Parulkar's family for honoring the association by participating in this condolence meeting, as well as I would say it is honoring his memory, and it's wonderful that everybody could participate and share their experiences. It opened the door for a lot of us who did not know him so intimately. Of course, we'd heard so much about him, and we always looked up to him. But a lot of new light was shed, I would say. Going forwards, we would, I think, I can comfortably say on behalf of the association that we would like to do something which would keep his memory alive in the association, maybe in the form of a named lecture or in the form of annual symposium. But I would certainly like to welcome ideas from all of you as to how you think that we could keep his memory alive as a periodical event in the association. So please mail me or Hiremat with your suggestions, and on behalf of the association, I would certainly like to take that forward. So I'd conclude by thanking all of you again, once again, for this occasion. And this is difficult times with the COVID. I pray that everybody stays safe, and we still haven't won the battle, but I hope that in the near future, we'll all be able to meet in person rather than on video calling right now. So thank you once again. And good night to all of you.
Thank you. Request all to take care of yourselves and be safe. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Be safe.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Good night. Thank you.
Thank you.